My name is Chi Feng. I teach oil painting at an academy of fine arts. This is the first time I've picked up a paintbrush in the past 2 years.
画画这件事吧，我认为不可强求，因为我自我感觉就像写作一样词穷，或者说没有生活了，或者没有体会了。
This time, I'm picking up my brush because of a green train journey I took 3 months ago.At the end of 2017, I boarded train 4083. This train departs from Jialong wetlands, crosses endless snowfields, passes through Bei'an, and reaches the lesser Xing'an range. The fishing, hunting, and farming cultures of the wetlands, plains, and mountains of northeast China are brought together and combined into a whole by the wheels of this train.
我现在来目的是个啥不？这你说是多危险啊！我就给演个小护士去，小黄就把事儿给办了。往你这一站，后面过几个人，你瞅着我，没看着后面那人。
他们的那种工作方式，更接近于一种生活状态的工作方式。比如说，乘警去提醒一个乘客要把自己的财物收好，他可能开一个小玩笑，用一些比较诙谐幽默的语言来和对方去交流。
检票员同志请注意，开往到哈尔滨方向去的动6926次列车现在就要开车了，请停止。
These flying red-crowned cranes are bred artificially in the wetland reserve. But what I really want to see are the wild red-crowned cranes. The local people tell me that it's not difficult to see them in the villages and reed marshes around the wetland, even in the midwinter. I meet my first friend on this trip at the entrance to Jialong village. He is Xu Chuanfu, a successful reed trader.In order to see how the local people live, I go with him when he drives into the marshes to buy reeds from the villagers.
咱这路也那么大面积，
不是咱齐哈尔市，一个市还有那啥呢？大庆市，对，都是咱们这一个芦苇荡连着呢。
苇的纸质没有弯，达到硬度，生长期要足够，不受虫害，这样的芦苇健康，长得就漂亮。
把那嘎子几对矮的甩出去，剩下装吧。那里边我跟你说，好大一块不行的啊。
那北头，瞅一下子，北头那行吗？
但是咱俩说，这回指定是不敢再好。
要不要啊？
不要，先加了。
这啥话？
去吧。
因为之前我见到的芦苇地都很小，但是那么大面积的芦苇我第一次看到。尤其我们用那个无人机飞在空中去拍的时候，当时我觉得挺震撼，没想到有那么大的芦苇地。
从哪块来？
杜尔伯特。
你刚从杜尔伯特来。
After saying goodbye to Xu Chuanfu, I meet Dorbod resident Wu Hongwei. He tells me that Dorbod and Jialong are separated by this reed marsh. During the harvest season, he and other villagers will travel across dozens of kilometers of ice fields to help villagers in Jialong with the harvest. They go back to Dorbod before sunset.Wu Hongwei agrees to meet with me tomorrow and go to Dorbod together.
看到这个雪底下覆盖的这个冰层，我突然发现我自己站在是一个湖泊。夏天的时候，它可能就会变成了一个有仙鹤，
然后有鱼生存的这么一个沼泽地。
Early in the morning, I arrive at the appointed place. The guys from Dorbad are already at work.
那他们吃完都运哪儿啊？
有一部分发到山东吧。嗯。完了，去年还有那个外国人来买来了。
There's always a surprise in store in Jalong's reed marshes. The fascinating wild red-crowned cranes decide to make an unexpected appearance.After leaving Jalong, Wu Hongwei and I travel across dozens of kilometers of frozen river to get to Dorbad. We run into Jalong fisherman Wu Junfeng and his brother Wu Junzhou in the middle of the marshes.They tell us that driving on ice is extremely dangerous, and we have to know the wetland ecosystem very well.
那这三九天是不薄薄？
这就是天然的。为什么鱼不死？鱼就搁这里待了，鱼就靠着这个气，它能活着。要如果说整个跑了，大跑都封严了，要没有这种情况下，那鱼全部死。看，越到三九天还开呢，都跑大车，这嘎就是水。打春的时候的洞，九天一开，这就是葫芦草。这个，揉完以后去鞋不用袜子，完了抖丝，
你看，这个是好了，这就可以去鞋了。
In the afternoon, I enter the wetland in Dorbad. Here, the cattails steal the show from the reeds.With Wu Hongwei's guidance, I find Zhao Feng, a resident of Ho Wu Dai village in Dorbad. He's the only person in the village who knows how to make chicken cages out of cattails. An hour later, Zhao Feng's chickens have a new home for the winter.
生下来养鸡，咱这下蛋的时候，没说懒跑呀，我给它固定个地方，把它放那儿，它就上那下去。
现在没人收了，给也我都不要啊。
Dorbad is the transition zone between the Jalong wetlands and Mongolian grassland. It has a very different geographical landscape.During the journey, I pick up my sketchbook for the first time, and then leave Dorbad. When I get back to Jalong, the people from Dorbad are leaving. At sunset, I bump into reed painting artist Li Yongfu, who is selecting materials. This is the best time of the year to collect raw materials for reed paintings.
This白度，这都够。哎，就像这个似的。
对对。
哎，一摁它弹起来，一摁弹起来了。
粗线就是说，这就是一个最低标准了，也就这块有几根儿，我看还。还可以，剩下这些细的根本咱寻思都别寻思，这根本都不行。
Li Yongfu doesn't have much to show after a day of selection. He is concerned about the decline in the quality of reeds.
今天这个尾指实在是真不好。
什么东西能导致它，比如说又长得又有弹性，然后它那白度、纯净度又好？
一个就是髓质的事儿。人家说前几年我有时候就是芦苇质量非常非常好，就这几年有点退化。它这玩意儿要一旦伤了以后，多少年以后它都恢复不过来。要包前四五年，整个扎龙这头的尾子，都是出口，一个是日本，一个是美国，因为南方没有这么细的尾子。
咱们选主要为主，这细的吧。
The next morning, I come to Lee Yongfu's studio to learn about reed painting. Soaking. Slicing. Cutting. Ironing. And splicing. In Lee Yongfu's hands, nature's creation becomes part of man's spiritual life. It's time to say goodbye to Jialong. The night before leaving, I decide to commemorate this trip by making a drawing from reeds and cattails.
我本来想用芦苇这个材质，结合着我自己的画的风景和一天在这个芦苇地里的感受去创作一张小画。
好像画挂不下来，先这样来点再说吧。
其实中间有点失败，因为我没考虑到这个芦苇这个它那个形状是什么样的。
哇，粘是一个很大的失误，我没想到那棒棒，它竟然掉的不是木。他竟然掉的是毛，宝宝不开心。
看来还有一线生机。
有啊，就搞不下去了就反复搞嘛。
后来通过大家的鼓励，我还是做成了，而且我觉得我还挺满意的。
At 5:48 in the morning, I board train 4083 once again. 12 hours later, I will enter the territory of the Orochin people. The train leaves the Jialong wetlands and enters the boundless snowfields of northeast China. Bei'an is an important station on the route. Here, the train makes a 90-degree turn and begins to head north. The number of passengers sees a sharp drop, and the landscape begins to change, with plains turning into hills. In the afternoon, I have a new neighbor. His name is Liu Shujiang. He is a Han Chinese who breeds horses and hounds for Orochin hunters.
我现在家有11条狗，猎狗，要是稍稍猪再小一点的啊，二三百斤，咱们的狗自己就把它抓到了。要是大一点的情况下呢，那就得开枪打了，因为俄军有枪。
大的有多大？
大的得有四五百斤、五六百斤的都有。对，到你班了。哦、俄军人就这样到你班了。哎，我就搁那学的这个，是的。来，你来块肉。
到我班。
哎，就轮。
哎，
这肉
太
有，
这是肉干啊，
肉干
自家做的。
嗯，
完了，那下一层呢？
嗯，这确实。
但是我酒量不行，每次就二两。
完了，这回不轮了，这回我都装没了，
没了。
我们现在坐的高铁都是每个人都朝着一个同样的方向，但是绿皮火车不一样，绿皮火车还像以前那种火车。就是说有很多的时候我们可以面对面的去坐在一起，然后其实这样慢慢的就一种有可能会大家交流起来。然后我坐在这个车上没感觉这个车厢里头这些人的生疏，反而觉得他们都有交流。
I transfer to a bus in Heihe, and 2 hours later, I finally arrive at the mysterious Xinsheng Orochin ethnic town.As I walk along this exotic street, I feel both nervous and excited. There are hides hanging under the eaves. I am so intrigued that I have to knock on one of the doors.
This 鹿角上面也有这毛哈？
有。
它一直都长着吗？
春节前后开始长这个绒。
这眼睛还挺有神的。
小不点的，不伤神的。有点玩的时候玩带，不上山打猎，上山打猎一般都不带着。
嗯，为啥呀？
我为啥 以前打猎的人挺多，
嗯，
怕别人看着当跑着打了。
哦。
Meng Lanjie is an Orichin Road deerskin clothes maker. These skins are buried under wet sawdust for 2 days. The time is crucial. It has to be 2 days. If the skins are left for more than 2 days, they will rot. Less than 2 days, and they won't be soft enough, which will make it hard to remove the impurities from the surface.
那个袍套着套着皮的发红不血了，皮儿还硬，再说好了它也是发挺，枪打的皮子软化。
Combing the skin is the most demanding part of the clothes making process. A piece of roe deer skin has to be combed for an entire day until it is soft enough for the next step, the removal of impurities.This scraper is very effective in removing the remaining flesh and fat on the skin.
要是个小的、瘦点的，五个。你看这个皮子是多点儿，这才多点皮子，跟它一比差多些。这是两年的皮子，可能当年的袍皮比这还小呢。
After scraping off the impurities, she starts sewing. The Orichin people do not use thread to sew the skins.Using the rubbed tendon of the roe deer instead.
袍筋和这袍皮本身自己就生虫子的，包烟是防虫子的。这这上有那个哈喇皮子，还有肉。那些线这搓线的都披着被子，这个搓裤线裤搓到这，那个肉皮上搓这样式。
哦，
这玩意不行这个。
The trousers are also made of roe deer skin. Orichin people can't rub the tendon without them.
This is a wound. This is a wound. This is a wound. This is a wound. This is a wound.这个皮子是搁那个海拉树的皮子，那么白。
From soaking to sewing, it takes Meng Lanjie more than half a month to make a roe deer skin coat. When I put it on, I feel like I've become a real Orichin man.
真正的袍皮衣。
Meng Lanjie recommends that I go to visit Wu Nan, the youngest hunter in Xinsheng town. I set off early the next morning to see him.
看这儿，看这儿，他是小的时候给他豁了。
为什么呢？
为了让他那个撵东西嘛，追赶猎物的时候，他能有长劲儿，一直跑一直跑，他能倒气儿，能倒过来气儿。哎，我在这儿还加个圈。护林的时候，
哦，
受伤袍子经过回来了，救助他们。什么时候好了，看看养好再说吧。
I've come at the right time. Wu Nan is going to hunt in the mountain today, and agrees to take me with him. 。Every winter, Orichin hunters wait for heavy snow, as animals can't hide their footprints when the ground is covered with snow.
现在这个季节打猎不好打了，猪都散帮了。有些群孤猪还没出群，孤猪护群呢，猎狗一去，哎，先碰着它，然后孤猪已经那个头上雪的时候，它有那个一层厚厚的膘。现在把膘都靠没了，打架相当煞了。几个狗，要是碰出好猪的话，全都扔那儿。
After driving for half a day, Wu Nan finds traces of wild boars. He decides to camp here, switching from car to horse to continue his hunt. After finding a good spot, I help Wu Nan build camp. Wild boars are near us, and we could start hunting at any moment. The film director gives me a camera to record this thrilling moment. I start to feel a bit nervous. Before the hunt begins, Wu Nan follows the origin tradition of paying tribute to the mountain god.
Bai Na Sa, Si Ma, Bi Mai Yi Ma, Tong Hei Hai Dan Bu Er, Wu Le, Han Hei Ma.
新碰过的雪，它这个反光面棱角特别多。如果是时间长了以后，它这个棱角，这些棱角全被风给吹掉了。然后就变得非常暗淡了，那就是旧印儿。这样棱角多的就是新印儿。先判断跟着新印儿走。
跟上走。
看着猪有拱过的痕迹，猪就快要停下了。就得带着猎狗打猎的话，就得注意狗的动向了。看狗要是一跑，那就是非常有可能就在跟前儿。
After Orochin hunters catch a boar, they usually give its intestines to the hounds and hang the rest of the organs on a tree to stop the hounds from stealing them.
Hey, here. 给你尝了你不吃，这不是给你吃的。
所有地方去旅行，你之前的想象和你实际到了那个地方都会有差别，因为看图片、看画面看到的风景和你在现场看风景是不一样的。尤其黑河那个小兴安岭那林场里头，它够大，然后就是你能感觉到自己的就是在这个空间里头所处的那种位置或者状态，就是人会很小。我们这一个组里头的五个人天天在一块儿，首先就特别开心。每个人的做事儿或表达事情的方式不同，所以给大家带了很多的笑点和很多的开心的时刻。
This train running through the mountains is the only green train on the Sichuan Chongqing line. Every place the train passes through has beautiful scenery, but that is not what this trip is about. Join us for the next part as we travel to ancient towns that have been forgotten by time.